That's really a difficult question. Ministry is okay, but then it's a little bit. I'm careful to use the word challenging. The reason being that America is huge, and we have diverse cultures, and we have different people that is situated in the country. So if you want to do music, you want to be mindful of the content you're choosing and the language, especially to transcend to that culture as well. So I know the common culture or the common language that we all know is English. So even if you're trying to do an account song, you want to do an English version so people who don't understand the dialect can understand what you're trying to do. So pushing that across, I know that becomes a challenge. Okay. The other thing is that because the market is vast and you are competing with the Kirk Franklins and all this stuff, you are just a tikoji. How can you compete with Kirk Franklin? It's a lot of work to get to that level. But I know that it's a step that you have to just keep going. Consistency definitely will get you there. So I would say personally for me, I just keep being consistent. And then I also try to build relationship with people who are up there to guide you along the way, because I know for sure that there is no way I can do it on my own. So somebody who is already out there can also guide me. A typical example is I'm very close to JJ Hairston a lot. Okay. Since he is based in the US, sometimes he gives me advice as to how to navigate my music through the US culture, and he will tell you that get registered with Stellar. So make sure you're a member. Make sure you're a member of the Dove Awards. Mm. It's not like they're going to give you the award tomorrow, but once they know you're a member, it tells them that you want to be associated with us. So these are some of the guys they can get from who are there. And I would say that financially, it's not a joke, because you want to promote your song in Ghana. And definitely, if you are the only person supporting yourself and you're living abroad, it's a lot living abroad already, and then trying to push money into your content. So there's a lot here and there, but I think in all, God has been faithful. And with grace, we'll get there, but we are not there yet. That's what I would say.
Great. So I want to ask, is there anything like US gospel industry?
None that I know of, personally. If it exists, then I'm not aware of it. Mr. Humphrey, are you aware of anything like that? No. But I know
in general,
gospel industry like in US.
If you say gospel industry, do you mean like gospel musicians?
Like Ghana, we have gospel industry. Gospel industry.
No, I don't think I'm aware of anything like that.
Okay, so what do they do? What do they do over there?
When you say gospel industry, it's very...
I mean, since there are gospel artists in the country,
then there's an industry. But not that should, but there's not like a board...
No, but it should be...
No, but there's no
any association be our any company that should be our. We just use the term.
No, there's no like
we just use the term like there's an industry.
So I don't think I'm really familiar with any board that sits to say that they are managing like an industry like the gospel or the secular artist. But I know for sure that we have somebody like Dundee Production that organizes Ghana Music Awards that tries to bring a lot of the Ghanaian artists that are in the diaspora. I think that is one of the huge platforms I can think of on top of my head, that when we do gather at that event, you get to see all these other phenomenal ministers that you don't even know they are even in the US.
Yeah.
That is one platform, but I don't think we have any industry that a board sits over to say, okay, we have a board and we have members. That I don't know.
Okay, so let me break it down. So do you guys have something like the Ghanaian gospel artists in the US? You guys have a WhatsApp platform, a group that you are in or something?
No. The reason why we don't have that is that I think because US, we deal with states, and each state is very, very huge.
Okay.
Unless somebody intentionally decides to say, okay, I want to bring all the Ghanaians in Maryland together to create a platform for them, that they can do that. But I don't think so. I am on some platforms, but it's a mixture of Ghanaians and US artists on there. But it's not like a typical US-based artist platform that I know of. And I think because Mr. Afia, correct me if I'm wrong, I think because our states are so huge and everybody's doing their own thing, so it's very difficult to bring, unless you want to just center it on a state. Like, if you want, we'll get there.
I'm suggesting, can't it be possible you guys will create a platform that you all been?
I can do that. But can you put it on my to-do list?
Yes,
I can do that.
I think the reason I'm saying that
is to start something and get everybody to join.
Exactly,
right?
To help you you guys now, nah, it will help you because okay. I think that when you guys are on the same page, you can even support yourself. Right. It's easy to support yourself on that same page.
Right.
It's easy to, I mean, send a message to that same page.
Right.
So I'm just exactly even do projects and other stuff together. So I'm suggesting maybe if you guys can.
A lot of you guys.
Yeah. So I think last month.
And it's something like maybe US gospel artist. Maybe your WhatsApp platform where you guys all will be in.
Yeah, I think the WhatsApp, is, I would love to do that. But just 2 weeks ago, another minister from New Jersey called me and she said that she wanted us to organize a concert for the U.S. artists, like the award-winning artists. So like we take Melissa and Yankee, we take myself, and she has also won some awards. She wants to put all of us together. And I was even thinking that if we want to do concert, you know, pretty much it's a lot of money. So I have a place, so we can use, I can leverage my church relationship and then we can use our church to do that, which is a good idea. Or we can do like a living room experience where like all those award-winning artists will gather in it, like in one space, like how these artists are doing right now in the US. And then we can do like a powerful worship experience. Everybody can go through their own songs. So that is something that is in the pipeline that we're just thinking about 2 weeks ago. So that is a good question.
Okay, my next question is a bit difficult, but let me ask.
Wow.
My next question is a bit difficult. I think I've been asking this question
for some
time now.
Why are you asking me a difficult question then?
Because I want to know your view. Okay. Why is it that the Ghanaians living here, Ghanaian gospel artists living in Ghana, we do song and we target the global market. The likes of Joe Metal, Dynamics, we all want to hit the global market. Why are you guys in the group, let me say it, already in the global market, the likes of US, UK, and you do songs and you target the Ghanaian market?
Okay.
Why?
So it's two things. I personally, when I do song, I don't target the Ghanaian market, I target the global market.
Okay.
But the global market starts from somewhere.
Charity
right?
begins at home.
Exactly. It starts from somewhere. And I think that if I start from my state, right, where I come from, Maryland, I can say that a lot of people know me from my state, Maryland, there. I've done some shows in New Jersey. I've done some in New York. At least the name is getting situated. But the reason why I always want to connect back to Ghana is that, first of all, this is where I'm born, right? And somebody might have heard Hetikoji somewhere or heard a name, but you can't even put the face of the name because I've been away for a minute. So I think coming here to connect to my own people is a good way to start. Also, you know, giving back to the community where I started and also building that fan base. And then also targeting other countries as well. So I personally, I don't do just Ghana. I get my songs have been played in Nigeria as well. I have my songs being played on US radio stations as well. So it's a personal thing. People have personal preferences. And and then people have personal preferences. That's how they want to promote their stuff. But my mind is global. That's why I tell you that I want to go to the Grammys. You remember I mentioned that? So Grammy is global. So
So since you mentioned you want to go there, can you share with us some of the steps you want to take to reach there?
Yeah. So the first step, as I said, is I have registered for the Stellas Award. I'm a member now.
On the Stellas, can you elaborate more on it? How is it doing? maybe most of the upcoming ones will want to, be part of
want
it.
To learn.
Because maybe something we are kind of anticipating. We want most of our artists here to hit the global.
Okay.
And most of these steps, we don't know. So you there, share with us. Yeah.
So pretty much, what you do is like, it's free. Not free to be a member, but just free. Just go and Google like Stellas Awards, and then when it pulls up, you see their website, you can register as a new member. Now, what you do is that you pay an amount. I don't know whether yearly it changes, but as and when I did it last year, it was a certain amount. You pay an amount. They ask of your name and everything.
How much?
I can't mention it. I'm a security person, so for security
reasons.
No, but
I give us like from, let's say,
$1,000. So it's between $200 to $700 based on some things that you want to do on the platform.
Great.
Now, when you register, they will ask for your YouTube links. They will ask for some artist profile. They want to know who the person is. And then when you join the membership, right, there's this email that they send to welcome you to the community. They call it community. And then once they start putting nominations out for those Stellas, they will send an email to say, look through it and see which of the categories well aligned with what you do. So what I'm trying to do, that's why I told you that relationships are very important. Right. And I started building this relationship with JJ Hurston. He loves African community. And most of the time, when you start building a relationship and they know that they don't create a lot of categories that benefits the Africans or the way we do our kind of songs, they'll think about it and go like, ah, we have a lot of people who does this kind of song, so we can create a category that can also put, I mean, support what they do. You get my point?
Yeah, I get
because of course when you nominate me and Tasha Cobbs in the same spot, her song is more like their thing than my kind of song.
Exactly.
But when they know that I have my kind of song, which is equally
your
English
kind of category.
But then we have about 1,001 people like me who also do the same thing. They'll be moved to do like a category for us to benefit us. So that is one of the conversations I personally have had with DJ Rest, the way we did the setting. And I know that it's a process, but for the fact that you've been able to even, I mean, sign up to be a member, it's a good thing. It's
and
a
I think,
step in the
I
right
think
direction.
You'll be the first, since you've actually decided to take this step, you'll be the first person maybe to be on the Stellis.
I receive it.
And amen. And I think maybe after that, you share the secret with us.
Amen.
How Joe Metal, the lights can also follow.
Amen.
No, why are you, it's like you are. Right.
Amen.
Because Stellis is a bigger platform. Yes. I mean, have you ever been to the awards? I mean, the D-Day. Have you ever been to the awards show before?
I've not been, but I've watched on the television.
Okay,
I've
so
not
how
been
is the experience?
Room. It's epic.
Serious?
It's not even a joke. You see, the thing is, even US, there's something that they do that I like a lot. When you get nominated, right, for Stellis or Dove Awards, and you don't even get any award, the fact that you are nominated for that, just the fact that you get the nomination, gives you a different brand as an artist. So when they're even addressing that particular,
exactly.
They go like
stand a
Stellar Award nominee, a Dove nominee, kind of Grammy nominee. You've not even won, but the fact that so that's what I'm saying. It's a huge thing to even get yourself nominated. So that is the goal when we are getting there.
Yeah,
eventually. The Lord will help us.
Is there a structure in the US? Like how in Ghana, maybe you release a song and as an artist, maybe you have to hit Precious app.
Precious,
you want,
are you recording?
You want radio promo, you want bloggers, you want radio promo, you want bloggers, you want TV station. Is there a structure in US on how to promote your song?
Yes, there is. So the radio stations have their structure. The TV stations, for my states, right? I know, America's structure is different. Every state does things differently. What will work in Kumasi will not work in Accra. That's how America is built. So what will work in my state as Maryland might not work in New Jersey.
Okay.
But I think New York has those structures a lot, but they do everything. My states, no. The radio is more. So a typical example is Kirk Franklin has a radio channel,
right?
And so what they do is that when your song is out and you want your song to be promoted on that channel, and that is one of the channels that I got my song from, they will vet your song and make sure that your song meets their criteria, because every radio station have their sound that they want to produce. So when it meets their criteria, then you said, okay, first thing first, your song has met the criteria, but these are the charges. If you want to promote for a month, if you want to promote for 2 months, then they'll give you somebody that you work closely with. So based on the package that you choose, they'll do the promotion for you.
Right.
So that is how they have that structure there.
Right.
So unless you want to know, but if you don't research, you wouldn't know that there's a structure in place for you to get your song played on the airline. But what I can emphasize on is that they don't compromise on quality. So if your song is not good enough, they won't even consider you at all. That one is not like Ghana, that sometimes the song is not great, but they will play it regardless. That place, if it doesn't meet their sound quality, they won't even play it on their radio station. Is that?
So even when you give money for their own play.
Yes, even if you give them $1 million, they won't play because their quality,
they
won't compromise on it.
They have
the standard, they can't compromise on that.
Yeah, so do you know of any gospel blogger in US?
That's a good question. I see, the thing is, I have people blogging on my stuff, right? After I see all these other blogs, and I don't really know who they are. I go like, who are these people? But all I go to say is thank you for blogging. Yes, I know one. I think one of them even did an interview with me. I think it's a Sanewa or something. There's this gentleman who is doing great. Yes, he's doing great. A few of them, but I don't know them personally. All I see is like the online correspondence. When you post your stuff, they'll pick it up and repost it for you, and that pretty much does it. But I don't... And tag you on those posts as well.
Okay. All these questions were like, I was trying to connect a dot so we get to a particular point.
Okay.
So now... It's like not just we are saying it, but we are trying to, make it more visible.
Yes.
The way, the steps, how to get there.
Yes.
Now, the question is, what are your plans for next year?
That's a good one.
Yeah.
I have a lot of plans. But Mr. Kansu, I'm just kidding. So, I'm working on my album, which is due to be released next year, God willing. And I'm also working on some collaborations as well.
Is it local collaborations or
local and international? Collaborations as well.
Great.
And then next year, I'm also hosting Overflow Concert 2022 in the US. So, and there's some other plans that I'm planning to do something in Ghana too. So all are in the pipeline. And for sure, once I make the decisions on those other ones, you'll be the first to know.
Great. Yeah. My last question, I'll allow other bloggers to also ask you questions.
Sure.
How do you see the Ghanaian gospel industry and the Nigerian gospel industry? What do you think the Nigerians are doing right that we are not doing? What do you think Ghanaians are doing right that? What's your whole overview on Ghana and Nigeria gospel industry?
So, I personally, when I was planning my concert last 3 years, one of the people that were supposed to be on the show was Travis Green and then Tim Godfrey, right? So Tim Godfrey, we spoke, and then there were some few things that he said, and then I knew how the Nigerian artists operate, and they operate differently. So they look at the and that is my relationship, that is how I based on how I dealt with him. They do ministry, but they make sure that they do it the right way, and the business
they don't joke with
up front.
Yeah.
So if you want to host somebody on your show, you want to make sure his ticket is ready. You want to make sure his hotel is ready. You want to make sure you explain everything. Okay, what is the show about? You know, the expectations are set for both parties. And then when they come in, they know what to expect. Unlike sometimes when some people want to organize shows in Ghana or even some part in the world, or let's say like America, and you go like, oh, yeah, my friend, so come, you know how like US, oh, like in some people say,
brah,
supporting me.
Yeah.
If their artists, their managers will not even allow that kind of support business. Yeah. They'll come and support, but they want you to still pay them. And so most of the time, I think that we do it based on relationships a lot of the time, and I think that is what is setting us. The other thing is that Nigerians who are making it are really paying like they are. I think consistency is one of the key things.
Investment.
And they invest in themselves a lot. You see Nigerians, so my show, I was honored to invite the music director for Experience Nigeria. Mm-hmm. He was the one who came to do my Overflow concert for me. I flew him to do my concert, and I learned a lot of things from him. See, his thing is, he invests a lot into his craft. And after he has invested a lot, now he's not the one chasing the platforms. They are chasing him because of the quality and what he has built for himself. So I think for us, let me speak to myself, I don't want to mention it, for me, it's worth spending on myself and investing in my craft.
Hit that point too. Most of our local artists here, they don't even want to hear the word invest.
Yeah, I'm saying it to myself. So for me, I think it's important to invest in myself, work on my craft. Just like we're talking about the global thing, because there's a lot of things that are changing in the music industry every day, every time. So for you to be relevant, you have to also be on top of the game. So investment comes to play, and all this investment also boils down to money. So I'm not saying you should have $1 million to make it, but the little that you have, channel the resources to the right place that will really, really help you to be the best version of yourself. And I think, the platforms will chase you.
Well, for the sake of those watching us, I want to add my voice on this, the investment part. Most of our artists here, they don't like investment.
I beg to differ. Mm-hmm. It's not that they don't want to invest, but the resources are not there.
It's true.
And the support is not there. So for me, it's a risky game for those of us in the industry, because there are people we feel they don't have, but they have the gift, they have the talent. Mm. How can we push them? Mm-hmm. Now, these same people you support to a certain level, where you feel at this point they can afford. But here's what happens. When they get to the point where they can afford, and they'll go for Zion Felix, or they'll say, oh, your platform is too small, let me go for a bigger one and pay them.
Right.
So it's why investment will go.
Right.
That is the problem now.
Okay.
That is why sometimes I understand it when people are like, hey, me charges me, can I come and call me baby?
Right.
I don't believe in baby. But the NSASWA is not going to help a lot of them, because we cannot put all of them in one box. There are people who are grateful, who appreciate the little you do for them. And some people too constantly want to ask for free things. Yes, I am willing to do it for you for free, but I, sitting here, believe in sacrifice.
Right.
So yeah, tension is prone over to how many people. No, they have to credit your good phone, so just do it. Or even say, you hear that, oh, this lady has been supporting me all these years. She's celebrating her birthday. Buy her a bottle of non-alcoholic wine. she will appreciate it. But if you want to say, we don't have, support me, push me. We go on, we still do it. But we're getting to a point where we learn how to sacrifice and don't take people for granted. I know you are a student, but you have a gift and we are trying to support you. So that is the thing.
To take it from where you came in.
Yeah.
The reason I was saying is that they don't want to invest in themselves. Mm. And Tigodi sitting now, I know that she let's face reality. It's not like she has a mansion of money or something that she's okay.
I get
but because of what she's doing and how she understands her ministry, it's her ministry. If you are not ready for ministry, nobody forces you.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we should invest in our brand. Let me use myself or the other bloggers as an example. We invested in our craft, we invested in our brands. Nobody was like, I can see, say you are promoting girls, we'll take, buy credit. It's we now our money. Sometimes we don't, you're last, you have to buy data to keep your page running, to keep your brand running. And then now, by God being good, you establish a very big brand and now people want to just come for free. It doesn't work that way. We invested in our brand. So if I don't support your brand, it's not like by force, why are you not posting my stuff? Why don't you? I don't owe you any support. No, I want to establish that. I'm getting
intentions right now.
Yes, because I just want to establish the fact. It's your ministry. See, it's your ministry. God gave you the talent. God gave you the talent. If you are not ready for you to execute the talent, wait. And don't just start the ministry because everybody's doing it and you come and be doing things anyhow.
You have to start anyway, any small thing, invest in it.
Don't joke with your brand. There's nothing like I have two CDs, so I'm doing it anyhow.
I always say this thing.
The way you begin your brand is how people will respect you for the rest of your life. If you start a brand on a very cheap way, people will see you cheap for the rest of your life. So even with a little, try and save something. It's your own brand.
We're having a forum.
When you become big and you enjoy it, nobody will be like,
What you're saying perfectly, but I believe that even as much as you have, I was telling her that Footprint TV those days, we used to give TV3, is it 2,000 cities or 1,005 for them to air for 30 minutes? And so every money we got, we paid airtime for that. A lot of people didn't know that. Now you come on Footprint TV and we say, oh, at least you know that we have cameramen, we have editors, we have people to sort out. But there are still people we still go out to do stuff for them, either for free or very reduced rate. Not because we've not invested in our brand, we have. But we feel that even with the big companies, MTN, at a point they still give out to society. So there should be a point where you as a blogger will say, no, this artist, at least,
But it shouldn't be like... some people think that we owe them a support.
No, you don't. Another day, you don't.
No,
but as a Christian,
and as a matter of fact, let me state it here. Mm-hmm. Most of our top gospel artists here, they think we owe them a support. Of course, if you start a brand, they will never patronize your brand.
So you are
bad. I said, you cannot see all my colleagues here. When we started our brands, they will never repost your content. Never share your reviews, your news.
I mentioned this in an interview with Celestine Donko. I said that I've realized that most of you gospel artists, in Shushenim, if let's say a big star posts your thing, immediately normal
people will see.
But when the bloggers, they keep showing you, like, who's in the one in charge of the hype also? On the woman, you're posting. But nobody will be anchor reposting. I'm like, it won't mean, thank you.
No, they won't.
That's a problem I have with them.
They will never.
For me, I'll randomly pick any song and use it for my TikTok or my reel or anything. I don't expect you to come and say thank you. I'm not doing it for you. But I feel safe. Once I put your song there, 100 people crap on a bit here. Mama have publicity for 100 people. Mama mention at least one reposted crap. Come and say, or just give me some emoticons or something or some emojis and then go. But
never.
That is the problem here.
They will never.
And I think that is the Ghanaian spirit. Who says secular artist oh, thank you, my brother. Thank you, my sister. It's me who, and I talked about it recently. So I understand. But for me, I feel the bloggers, you are doing a good job. But have the ministry at hand.
We have it, of course.
Now, Kupon, God blesses our motive and all that.
Exactly, the motive is what matters. You know, yeah.
Motive, okay. Now, who is setting up platform? Who's setting up all the better day?
No.
Say, yeah, there is a vacuum and you want to occupy so that we share gospel industry. Now, you say, we call gospel blog and I say, secular blog and I choke into my mind, call gospel, one of them, one of them. Who is that?
And
it's when you command. Sometimes a sacrifice, Christian work, no, a 90% sacrifice.
Right.
It's as a blogger, and if you understand this, maybe I won't share a bit for you about crying.
I love the point I'll raise, but I won't say my point.
Some of us sitting here,
we still do what you are saying.
Yes.
You uncle for promote you for free. A bit more point, anymore. Someone comment and fire. My point I'm establishing is, anybody owes you a support to your ministry.
Support.
The ministry is yours, and how you do it for you to stand is it's your own responsibility. Because don't forget, the Bible says, if God has given you a ministry, it is your duty to make the ministry work. It's not by force. As a blogger needs to post you before you know, nobody owes you anything.
So yeah, you told people to create your own pages too as an artist.
Exactly.
Create your own page, push your songs, you know. And I tell them that something the Nigerians do that we don't do is aggressiveness.
Yes.
Samson said that he hopped onto a bus to Ghana. He didn't know anybody in Ghana. He brought his CDs, walked from radio stations, I'm a Nigerian artist, so mommy. And also we Ghanaians, we have a heart for foreigners.
Yeah.
They all started playing his song. Mm-hmm. And before you know it, people are bringing him to perform and you're paying him big money.
Yeah.
That guts, is what we don't have as Ghanaians.
Some of us
naturally, we don't have it.
Yeah.
Nigeria or Haiti, even Togo, Ivory Coast, they love our music.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Before you know it, they're calling you over to come and bless them. That is what we don't. We are too comfortable. You're not doing a crazy piano. It's all okay. It's a problem. You wanted to say something.
Yeah, I wanted to add to what you said and what my brother was saying. See, last week I was talking to somebody, and I was telling the person that just like he said, this ministry, right? It's your own ministry.
Mm.
Because sometimes when you depend on people to support you, even a typical example is when I'm planning the Overflow concert. It's a lot, because sometimes you might feel like, okay, why is anybody not helping me? Why am I not getting help? Then I think the Holy Spirit will minister to me that it is your thing.
Mm.
And it's a truth. And so if you can ask her, and I think for all the people who know me personally,
yeah.
I don't play with when I'm doing something and I know it's my thing. So because I'm a trainer, it be a time I'm over here ready for me, you know. Not me pen in time. So me, I just take up, like what I do is I have my plan, like plan A, plan B. If plan B fail, I have plan C. Like I do it. That's how I structure myself. So when you're not come, before you come, I've already planned everything.
Yeah.
A typical example is my manager that I was working with in the US. The first of Apollo concert that I did, I brought a team on board, like this meeting, and I said, I want to do this concert. And then the team started asking, have you sorted out, what about lights? And I said, I've already sorted out lights, it's paid. What about sound? I said, sorted out. What about the, I said, I know the people at the place. They were like, you already did everything. I'm like, I just said to facilitate it, because when I'm on stage, I cannot be moving.
Mm.
So they were like, so you already know what you want to do. And that is what he's saying. It's your brand, it's your thing. If you don't put in the work, now also we're trained. Training by the different and then say support is all kind of, but you have to be aggressive.
Okay.
I mean, my pastor knows me for that aggression.
It's
when true. I want something, unless I don't want it,
that is what we
do. I'll
have.
Be asking, my pastor will be like,
I keep asking myself,
right? You have to
and
be aggressive.
The songs we have here in Ghana, even Nigerian production, but sometimes I say they always have issues with their sound. Even Sinach, your sound is good. Excuse me, say she's the top, but the sound crap, life for the sound. If you play music on radio, you understand. But for 5 years production, you take Ghanaian songs. If you tell them, I don't think I ain't even breaking God a virus. You ain't caught international.
It all depends on the artist here, our motive. We are not ready for what we are doing. Let me say it that way. Most of them are not ready for what they are doing. Obi office said your voice keke to akoshe studio are recording you mwewi. And one onim. Abuya born. The one said the following month was say release single. Onim ni oyo. you know, the whole year we're releasing single basis only the oil. So the thing is, most people are doing, most of our artists are just doing gospel because they are doing gospel. They are not doing because they want to do gospel. Yes, and Jesus revealed to me that, where did you see Jesus? So most of them are there, they don't know what they are doing. You see the questions I was asking you and answers you gave me, it has given me a different impression about you. You know what you are up to. So when we are coming on board to support you, we can see the picture clear. We can see the vision. Then that is where I can come in with all my effort to support your vision. By the moment artist wants you to promote his work for, and when you go to his platform, nothing is on the Instagram page. What do you want me to promote? And if you're the one on there, the quality is poor. You want me to put it on my brand, and then he says I don't support you. No. So I don't know if the other gospel bloggers, you have other questions.
Double sided way. His whole point is very true. But I think that we need to be patient for the up and coming. Patience for her. Your father, you ask all the questions.
Oh, no question. You don't want to know how the system works out there.
And I don't want to say that.
She said a lot already. But what I want to ask is about how they gain revenue from their music or their ministry. How do you do it over there?
So I'm registered with TuneCore. It's a publishing company that they collect your royalties for you, and then they post your song on all the digital platforms. So what I do is that, and that is why I do the overflow concert. Usually when I do the songs and I want to put the songs out there, I timed it in a way that it aligns with the concert. So when people come to the concert on the day of, we have about 500 plus or 1,000 plus people who come. That day, we'll make sure that they'll go on YouTube. I mean, some people will go on iTunes and get it. Some people will go on Spotify and get it. Those who don't get it, we pack the songs in a CD, nicely packed with all the logos and everything, and they buy it on the day of. So with or without going online, I still get to sell my song to you. So that instant, I sell the song. And the other thing is that you can also do, I do a lot of promotions as well. Like promoting, like Facebook promotion and Google Ads is one way to promote your songs, and then make sure it reaches a mass audience. And then, once they listen to it, when you do this Google Ads, what I know is that at least they snip your song to play about 30 seconds per every advert or something. And then somebody just hearing your name can go back and check you on other platforms. So that is how I personally get my revenue. Right now, I'm not looking at, just like you said about the investment, I'm not so much into the revenue aspect yet, because I believe strongly that when I build this thing to some level, and I don't stop being consistent, and I don't stop being aggressive and pushing, and trying to like push the gospel to some level, it's only a matter of time that whatever I've invested into the ministry is going to come back to me.
Exactly.
So that is the mentality I have, and that's how I'm moving with my brand.
Any more questions?
Ask questions.
Okay, mine is not a question, no, right? Like a contribution to what you're doing. Okay, with the gospel artists in the US, I've been seeing you both taking pictures together, and it seems there's some unity and love between you people. And we are praying it continues. Okay. Because if it continues that way, it will help you. It will help you people now. Because here in Ghana, there, Ojashios. So we are praying that the love you both show each other.
Ojashios,
sir.
No, what I mean is that the people that you see me taking pictures with, I usually want to talk to people for myself, because sure. I don't want to say sure. them. They got somebody sure. going to contradict me. Sure. So I want to use myself. The people that I usually take pictures with are people that I am cool with. And one person is Minister Humphrey, Minister Yankee. I know that she has a program for Sunday.
Sure.
And I also have a program that Sunday. But I called and I told her that I'll see if I can pass through quickly before I can go for my program. So that even shows that even me having a big program, I'm even willing to go support. Even if it's 5 minutes, just to show you that, look, I'm standing with you, but I cannot be there for the whole time. So we are cool like that. But I'm also praying to God that God will help us to be cool to the end. You know, we are human, so. Yes, it's true. Thank you. And we appreciate that.
Any more questions, Salas? You don't have any questions, Gina?
Yeah.
You don't have any questions?
I just came, so I'm just doing this.
Okay.
Hey, that's Antoine, I'm sure he's
precious.
Okay, so. We don't have any questions.
I think that she's his accent. Oh, yes.
Okay, so you guys don't have any questions. I'm ending it too. You don't have any questions.
Are you the official cameraman?
Okay. Okay, now.